Hello everyone, this is Adrian Bell, and today we will hear about a Costa Rican doctor that went on vacation in her home country at a five-star resort in order to just relax, but she ended up being victim of an unthinkable crime in a place that was supposed to be a paradise. Maria Luisa Cedeño Quezada was born on May 29, 1977, in San Carlos, Costa Rica. She was a beautiful woman who loved playing sports like running, swimming, and biking. She also loved nature and had an immeasurable love for animals, especially her inseparable friend, her little dog, Mafalda, that she always took with her wherever she went. At the age of 43, Maria was an anesthesiologist and head of the Anesthesiology and Recovery Service at Hospital CIMA in San Jose, Costa Rica, which is considered the top hospital in the country. She was very respected in her field by both her co-workers and patients. Maria was single and had no children. She had a reputation for being very independent, happy, and spontaneous. She was always smiling. Her family and friends described her as a very kind, dedicated, faithful, and sweet person, also as an excellent professional. Maria decided to take a three-day vacation with Mafalda. She went to a five-star resort called La Mansión Inn by Manuel Antonio Beach, an incredibly beautiful place that allowed pets. On July 18th of this year, Maria checked into the resort and everything seemed perfect. She was in touch with her friends and family, regularly sending them pictures showing her having a good time via social media. It was supposed to be a quiet, peaceful, and relaxing time for her and her little dog in paradise. And to start, it seemed to be just that. She was last seen on the evening of the 19th when she went down to the lobby to pick up a bottle of wine. Maria was scheduled to check out on the morning of July 20th, but she didn't. About noon, the hotel staff entered her room and found a bloody and gruesome scene with Maria's body being found wrapped in sheets on the bed. When the police and forensics arrived at the crime scene, things got even more disturbing. It was determined that Maria had been brutally raped and murdered. She had multiple wounds all over her body, including injuries made with a blunt object and stab wounds. She had bite marks on her cheek, chest, and arm, and injuries to her private parts. It looked as though she was also tortured, and her neck had been viciously snapped, breaking her cervical vertebrae, which caused her death. Maria had brutal defensive wounds. All of her nails were broken. It seemed like she had fought fiercely for her life. During the investigation, the police found fingerprints, DNA, shoe prints, and other evidence at the crime scene that led them at first to two suspects, Herrera Martinez and Miranda Izquierdo. Herrera Martinez is a 38-year-old Nicaraguan man that lives in Costa Rica, working as a stripper in a gay club while somehow living for free in the same resort for doing odd jobs. When he was questioned, the police noticed that he had multiple recent scratches, which was additional evidence against him. The other suspect was a 36-year-old man, a computer scientist named Miranda Izquierdo, who was staying at the hotel for the last 15 days while doing some telecommunication job. After further investigation, the police realized that a third person was involved as well. A very wealthy Dutch businessman, the 69-year-old Harry Bolden. He is the owner of the resort where Maria was murdered. The police linked Harry to the horrific crime after some of the bite marks left on Maria's body matched Harry's dental records. Harry has connections. He knows many celebrities, politicians, and has international business networks. He has a very important role in the tourism sector of Costa Rica. He was also friends with both of the other men involved in the murder. For whatever reason, the local media didn't release mugshots of the first two suspects to the public, but I was able to find this summary page that shows who is involved in the case from a Facebook page called Escriviendo, which is following the case closely. The lawyer of Herrera is not shown because he's a public defender, as Herrera said he couldn't afford a lawyer. You can find this page using the link below. The police believed originally that because there were two glasses at the scene, she could not be drinking alone. They assumed that one glass was for her and the other one for Herrera. But Maria's friend showed to the police evidence that Maria always got two glasses with a bottle of wine, one for the wine and the other one for water. Maria had sent her friends pictures of her dinner table saying that she was having a good time with her dog, Mafalda, and that it was obvious that Maria was alone and had no intention of meeting another person that night. As the crime is still under investigation, the first two suspects will remain in custody until the investigation is concluded. While Harry's lawyers convinced the court that even though the evidence against their client exists, it's not 100% reliable, also saying that the evidence is weak and Harry is already 69, so it's not fair to send him to jail. For this reason, Harry is now under house arrest with an ankle bracelet, and the authorities took his passport. And that's it. No danger of him leaving at all. It's important to note that even before the police had linked Harry to the case, he posted condolences for Maria's family and friends with touching and supportive words from his hotel. After being linked to the crime, he denied everything and keeps denying even having ever met Maria before the murder had happened in his hotel. Harry is having problems claiming his innocence, as it's all over Costa Rican media that Harry posted on his social media that he had two knee surgeries in the same hospital where Maria was the head of anesthesiology. And that's when Harry met her. Many people believe that during one of those visits, Harry could have invited Maria to spend a time in his resort whenever she wanted, as it was pet friendly, which motivated her as she wouldn't go anywhere without Mafalda. Many media outlets in Costa Rica said that Herrera, the Nicaraguan stripper, who had been living for free in the hotel for a year, was actually one of the lovers of the millionaire who owned it. They say that many witnesses confirmed this information, and Miranda was very close to both of them, and that Harry was also involved in recruiting male strippers to private parties and events. This information hasn't been confirmed by the police to this point, but you can see the sources using the links below. Another disturbing fact is that forensics believes that Maria's body was washed after the crime in order to eliminate as much DNA from her rapists as possible. And after they washed her body, they placed her on the bed and took her own saliva from her mouth and placed over the bite marks on her body in order to make it seem like she had beaten herself and this way confuse the authorities. After they planted the saliva, they wrapped her in the bed sheets. Forensics came to this conclusion because there was no other way for her saliva to be found on places that it would be physically impossible for her to bite on her own body, like her chest, for example. Researching the case, I found comments from Maria's family and friends on Facebook saying that they believe the case is not being properly investigated and that other pieces of evidence that would have already proven Harry's connection to the crime could have been gotten rid of by the police in order to protect the Dutch millionaire. They also wondered if any other women may have disappeared from that resort in the past and nobody ever found out about them. The hotel started a campaign asking for money online to help them to survive these difficult times, which generated a lot of outrage from many people. There were also some media outlets trying to portray Maria in a very negative way in order to blame her for her own murder, insinuating that she should not have been there alone or that she had a relationship with a hero, and many other absurd excuses that, unfortunately, are very common in cases of rape and murder. Somehow, to some people, it will always be the victim's fault in one way or another. About Mafalda, Maria's dog, she was found alive after the murder, and according to many comments on Facebook, it seems like a friend of Maria will be taking care of her permanently. For now, we will have to wait along with the Costa Rican people until the end of the investigation to see who will be found guilty for it, and if the millionaire Harry will actually be held accountable. To speak to this point, the lawyers of the Dutch Harry and the Costa Rican Miranda are trying to rule their clients out of the case using lack of strong evidence as an excuse, and there is not a lot of information about the defense of the Nicaraguan Herrera, as he has been assigned a public defender. The Association of Medical Anesthesiologists of Costa Rica sent a letter to the Ministry of Public Security demanding justice, saying that all the facts of this case should be clarified because it's outrageous that a person can't travel and be safe in a resort without having criminals brutalizing and killing them, then getting away with it. There are lots of unanswered questions about this case. Many people don't believe that the culprits will actually pay for their crimes, and it's all very disturbing. What really happened to Maria and that hotel? What about the CCTV footage? Why is nobody even mentioning it? There are many people saying online that the hotel got rid of the camera system and the police didn't go through it. If it's true, why would they be okay with that obstruction? Let me know what you think in the comments. If you like this video, please leave your thumbs up and subscribe for more content. Thanks for watching.